I think we are live. This is really exciting. We're back, or I'm back, I should say, doing another live broadcast. And this time, this was magical. I'm here on YouTube and I'm here on Instagram, live on both. And as I said last time, please do let me know who you are, where you're from, if you're watching. Also, if you can, let me know if there's any dodgy sound or anything like that. I'd love to know about that as well, obviously, so I can get that fixed. But yeah, I'm not quite sure where to look. So I've got comments here. I've got some comments coming in here. Got some people watching on Instagram. Tom has been ages. How you doing? And we got Simone. And oh my gosh, this is showing up my eyesight, really. But there's definitely people. Hello everyone on Instagram. And if you are subscribed on YouTube, then tune in on YouTube as well. It's a slightly better audio quality on YouTube because I've got the old mic hooked up with the guitar and everything else. It's all about live. And I'm also in the, how many weeks have we been in lockdown now? 4? I think it's coming up to 5 weeks here in Poland that I've been locked down with 2 very young kids. It's challenging. The most challenging thing, of course, is my hair. I do apologise. I've managed to get it off shot here, but here you're just going to have to deal with it for a little bit. What have we got? I'm a lefty on Instagram, according to Tom. Oh, no. Disaster. Look at that. That looks good there, doesn't it? That 339. My gosh. What a great guitar. But anyway, the kind of point of today's stream is all about, I'm going to be doing 2 new songs for this weekend for you guys to learn. And I've been asking people on our private Facebook group, as well as on Instagram and just everywhere else, what songs do people want to learn? And we're going to be learning 2 songs. I'm going to be learning them live on camera. So I figure it's kind of a fun thing to do. Because it shows you the process. I can kind of talk through the process I'm going through when I'm trying to work out a song by ear. It's obviously a little bit trickier than just trying to do it by tab, but you find your own way through it. So it's definitely something to do to develop your ear. And we're going to be learning Killing Floor, Howlin' Wolf, which is one that was recommended to me on the chat, on the Facebook, private Facebook group for YGA students. And it was recommended by Giovanni, who's really kind of active on there, and so I wanted to do this video. So the full lesson will be coming up on Saturday, but for now, we'll be working it out. And Blinding Lights by The Weeknd, because The Weeknd is awesome. We've done a couple of his videos in the past, and they're really, really great. And this song is just amazing, and we'll kind of try and do a beginner's version of that, so I'll be working that out as well. So let's just quickly take a break just to see who's saying hello. So on YouTube, we've got, yes, Miles Skywalker. I don't know your real name, obviously, but good afternoon from India. We got Rod's Guitar from Dublin in Ireland. We got Steve Finn. Hey, Steve, how you doing? And he's actually learning Who Did You Think I Was, which is the song that we did last week. The old, God, if I can remember it now. Funny that, isn't it? It basically all goes immediately out of my brain as soon as I finish with it from teaching the lesson. I'll just quickly give this a quick tune. Right. Can you guys hear the guitar? On YouTube, can you hear the guitar? Can you hear my beautiful tuning notes? Hello, buenos dias from Spain. We got Spain. And Rod, Rod Guitar in Dublin 9 is also watching with his 8-year-old son. Hey, and on Instagram over here, we got people. Hello from India, Franco. Hey, Franco, we got Guitar Pro, Harrison. How are you guys all doing? Sorry if I miss any of you. Let me know if you got any questions. It is all over on YouTube as well. But yeah, we're in the modern world now, guys. We're in the modern world. This is the future. So let's just crack on with this. So the first song that I want to learn is called Killing Floor by Howlin' Wolf. Again, recommended by Giovanni on our private Facebook group for YJ students. And I'm a big blues fan, so this one kind of jumped out at me straight away. I also noticed there's not that many tutorials for it. So let's have a quick listen to it first so you guys can kind of catch up to this track. Have we got any blues fans out there? So do give me a thumbs up on Instagram or comment if you're a blues fan, and same on YouTube. Are you a blues fan? Do you know this track? This is obviously some old school blues. So let's have a quick listen to it. So let's go. Just gonna check. Can you hear that? First step of learning any song is to be able to sing it in your head, really. Just be jamming over it, even though that is pretty tempting. Now, I tell you what, if there's anything I know about Gibsons, and certainly these 339s, that G string, bane of my life. Great guitar, awful G string. I probably need to get it in the shop, but I can't go anywhere, so I'll have to learn how to do it myself. So this Killing Floor, it is... fantastic. It's just you can hear straight away that it's a 12 bar blues. It's in A, and it's got a lot of kind of soul elements to it. So it's the kind of thing that you hear a lot in the 60s as well. So this is much earlier than that, but definitely it's got a lot of familiar ideas. So we're going to try and go through. I'm going to try and learn the exact parts for you guys. So yeah, did we have any blues fans in? Yeah, a couple of blues fans. Very, very good, very good. If you've not heard of this song or even Howlin' Wolf before, I'd highly recommend it because, my God, this guy's got, you know, if you can imagine this guy being recorded now in the modern day, you know, obviously where he was being recorded back then. I don't know if he's 40s, 50s, 30s. I'll have to have a look at that. But obviously it's just a mic in a room and it's all just peaking. Everything is just in the red. So it's just this distorted sound coming at you, but it's so raw. And I think his voice and his blues and his chops, he's just really awesome. So on YouTube, we've got Simone, who said the sound is good. We're going through an interface. Yeah, I'm going through an interface and OBS to try and get this sounding really good, man. Hopefully it's decent. And Herman is a blues fan and good morning from Amsterdam. Got someone in from Amsterdam. I like it. How's it going in Amsterdam? Is it? It must be pretty crazy to have a city like that. I visited that Amsterdam last year. Unbelievable city. Probably the busiest city I've ever been to. Literally came out the train station, could barely move. But a great city. So it must be crazy now if it's all kind of locked down. And Giovanni's in. Hey, Giovanni, this one's basically for you, dude. Hello from Cardiff. We got Lars from Denmark, who loves the blues. Well, you're going to enjoy this. So, let's give this a go. Let's give this a little bit of a go. So, I'm going to just try to do this intro. So, it's in the key of A. So, the first clues will be that essentially it's going to be using our four chord, our three chord. Going to be using our 1-4-5, isn't it? The A, the D, and the E in some respect. Okay, right, got a pretty good idea from that. So straight away you can hear this is a turnaround, isn't it? This is your equivalent of kind of But it's kind of much more upbeat. It's definitely major, and I think... I think there's definitely that melody in there, isn't there? Let's have another. Is there a melody? That's so cool, I love that. So we basically got this kind of triad at the top, haven't we? Where, we've got this, yes, so we've got this triad of E, root third, fifth, and we're bringing in that dominant seventh, aren't we? Remember, I will be doing a proper full lesson on this once I've worked it out, you know, with all the cameras and all the proper audio and everything else. This is just a funky thing. I'm going to be learning this anyway. Might as well be live on camera. And then down to the D. That triad again. Yeah, and then obviously the A. And you've got this really cool kind of 16th note strumming going on. I think like any blues of this day and age, you can be loose with that rhythm. You know, I wouldn't want to say, right, we're doing a down, up, 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 you know, on the one E and I think you've got to just be a little loose with that, because I guarantee someone like Howlin' Wolf will not play this twice the same. But basically, and that's the intro, isn't it? That is the intro. So let's have another listen to that. So, I reckon that's pretty bang on. Let me know if anyone thinks it's any different. Just going to quickly pop over to Instagram here, see if there's any comments. It's hard to see on Instagram, isn't it, when there's comments. People just come in and out. But yeah, lots of people joining, which is really cool. And so, over here, we've got Lars from Denmark. I said that before, who loves the blues. Excellent. Herman said, it's quit now. That's really good news, Herman. Very, very happy about that. Good morning from Rotterdam, from Joja. Joja, really nice name. Good morning from Rotterdam. And Giovanni said, thanks a lot for Killing Floor. We need to remember that the two guitarists of that song were Hubert Sumlin, who is the man. If you've watched any of the recent Crossroads videos, the Clapton concert, he's on that. He's still going and he can play. And Buddy Guy, woohoo, not bad, eh? So we got this intro. I mean, that's just the five chord. It's kind of just layered up as a dominant, I would say. Let's see how the rest of the track, see if I can get the rest of the track. Ah. Okay, let's have a look into this. Okay, so I'm hearing this melody, which for me is my Steve Cropper training. You know the Soul Man, Soul Man. Come in, come into. On a dusty road. that's apart from the awful vocals, that's Steve Cropper, who for me is one of my absolute favorite guitarists. And that melody, who would have guessed it? It's here, you know, I don't know, 20 years earlier, 30 years earlier. It's the same thing, but I feel it might be in a slightly different place. Let's have another listen. It just feels lower, doesn't it? Maybe there. It's the same. Wow. Let's see if I can. No. Maybe it's that. That's got more of a the kind of I can't even think of the word now, but it feels lower, doesn't it? I feel like you've got the kind of the brass section giving it the, and then the guitars are much more kind of chunking it up. Yeah, let's go for that. We can learn both in the lesson. And then you can move that around. Wow, I really, really love that. I'm glad I'm doing this one. For Steve, this is not your thing, which is absolutely fair enough. You keep going, Steve, on the John Mayer. Good luck, good luck, good luck. Right then, so here we have so far, and I feel like I'm getting there. Hey, Guitar Pro guys. Hello, everyone saying hello on Instagram. This is fun. So, I feel like we've basically got this track together. I'm going to have a little listen out for some more specificities that I can use in the videos. So we've got the intro, so let's just go for it. So, you know, as Giovanni said on the chat here, it does definitely feel like there's a couple of guitarists there. There's definitely some chunky, you know, and then for the D, you know, feels like that's going on. So this could be layered, and I think a more modern take on this would be, if I was to play this, you know, I would have a little bit of a play around. So I'd give it this. Now let me just. There's so many options, and I'd do it up higher as well. So I'd go. I think that. If I was playing it solo by myself, that's where I would play it, because I'm getting then a combination of the rich sounds, that lower end, and more those trumpets,
For the D, I might. Okay, so I'd do a combination of the two things. Let me know if that kind of works for you, if you're thinking that's kind of about right. And then obviously it repeats for the track, I'm imagining, so let's just have a little listen. My voice, mine. If I had a follow. My voice, mine. I'd have been gone. It's my second time. And then obviously you can shred all over. Crazy solo. Tell me that's Buddy Guy. Is that Buddy Guy? That's got a kind of crazy vibe that the Buddy Guy would bring, I think. But you can hear with that solo, I mean, I probably won't do that in the video because it's all over the place, but you can hear he's definitely, in terms of a theoretical thing, he's definitely moving with the chord there. So he's definitely thinking over the A. He's definitely going for like this. You know, he's going for that and bits of the... probably the minor pentatonic. When it goes up to the D, you know, you can hear he's reaching up to the D. So moving with that chord change. And just centering everything around there. So if I was to solo over that, I might start by just trying to do the Buddy Guy thing, just a little bit neater, as it were. So maybe start with that. And then that same little theme. Now it's actually very, very major, isn't it, this track? So I'd probably stick with that major pentatonic. That box two. Solo. Hey Franco, good to see you, man. You've come from there. I saw you there, and now you're here. I love this setup. So super cool. So I reckon that song's done. So what I'll be doing when I do the official video of this is I'll be doing that main riff, the basic 12 bar parts, and then how you can then adapt that to kind of suit your own. But I definitely, just because I'm here and this is just fun, I'm just gonna have a little jam over that. When my friend comes from Mexico at me, I should have went on. When a friend comes from Mexico at me, but no, I'm fooling with you, baby. I'll let you put me on the killing floor. I should have been. Have some fun over that. I just got to just try and keep that vibe going. Anyway, right, that's Killing Floor roughly. Giovanni, is there anything else you'd like to see in that lesson? If you're still watching, let me know if there's anything else you'd like to kind of watch. Anything else particularly from that track that you love?
that you'd like to see in the lesson, and I'll have a little look at that afterwards. So let's do Blinding Lights. Thank you to anyone joining us on YouTube or Instagram. I'm going to try and do Blinding Lights now. So Blinding Lights is by The Weeknd, and it goes like this. Epic intro, of course. Oh my goodness. Epic. Epic. So. Now then, with this track, we're off. Okay, so I'm sure a lot of you guys know this track, Blinding Lights. It's just a pop song that's out right now. The Weeknd, I just really like his pop tracks. I just think they're well worth, for a guitar player, not getting into too much detail, just doing a couple of nice chords. It's great for a beginner to be able to play along to a track that's on the radio. The main thing here, whenever I'm working out any kind of pop tracks, is the process that I go through. So I'm going to kind of go through that process, and it might help some of you guys to do the same thing. But the first thing for me is to identify the key of the track. And I use my pentatonic scales, you know, and I just literally kind of play through them up and down the neck until I find a place that works. And that really helps me identify the key. So I'll show you. So let's just try with this track. You can hear there. I've been doing this a long time, so I found that quite quickly. But that's the process, and when I've done it with students in the past, you know, it does take a while to get there, but you can hear as soon as you hit it and you start playing the notes, it does all fit, okay? Which is very good news. Then you can kind of just expand on that, maybe by playing the full scale, so the diatonic scale. So if that pentatonic works there, I might start bringing in the other two notes from the major scale. Just to check, I've really targeted that the right key. So let's just get that back and have a listen. You don't even have to do too much. You can turn me on just a touch, baby. I'm a cold, since it is cold and empty. No one's around to judge me. I can see clearly when you're gone. Cool. So for me, you know, just jamming around that pentatonic and that full scale, it works fine. So this is definitely the key. So it's going to be either based around the kind of E flat major, or it might be based around C minor. We'll have to see. We'll have to have a listen to that and see. But either way, that gives me a set of chords, you know, that I know I can use now. The kind of 1-4-5 in E flat major, and the 1-4-5 in C minor. Most pop songs are going to gravitate around those. So let's see if we can kind of really locate some of those chords. So let's go back to the start. And now this is the trial and error bit. Okay, so let's see what we got. This is the fun bit. But you got to just accept that it might take a bit of time. Maybe you can show me how to love, maybe. So, I did it relatively quickly, but that's the process I would go through basically every single time. So, Ollie says, hello, hello, Ollie, my man behind the scenes doing things. Merv says, I'm not sure if the song and playing are synced. Possibly not. It might come through and, I don't know, slightly delay it. But that's okay. It's just really, the song's really just there for me to work it out fundamentally. So, all those things, in those steps that I went through, it was first of all to find the key, to guarantee that that's the right key. That laid me out my set of chords that are constructed based on that key. And now I've that's where experience comes in. You know, I guess the right chords pretty quickly. But if you're doing this from scratch, you know, just go through methodically. So, you know, you can hear where the chords loop. So it's like chord, those rough changes. And I know it can be harder when there's a synth that's kind of like, ooh, atmospheric-y, but fundamentally just think, you know, where does that change? And know that in a pop song it's probably going to be every four beats, you know, once a bar, every two bars, something like that. So then it's just a case of, well, identifying that first one, so that first chord, is it this? No, not really. Is it maybe the C minor? And then you'd match that to the song and be like, it doesn't quite sound right, try another chord, and just trial and error until you get the first chord, then write it down, then add the second chord, and just go through it. It really is, anything ear training is a case of knowing the theory so that it gives you the basis, and then it's trial and error and kind of working through it. So in this instance, what we worked out was that the chords are F minor to C minor, then to E flat major, however you play it, and then B flat major. And it sounds like it's on a loop. So we'll stick with that. What I'll do in a minute is, because I want to do like a beginner's version of this as well, so we'll talk about how, where you might put the capo for that to work. That's a really interesting concept to go through. But let's just get that melody. Let me just first of all check if we got any more comments. So Giovanni says, thanks, I think it is perfect how you plan to do the lesson. I am more interested in the main riff and all the rhythm parts and the general vibe of the song. Awesome, awesome. So that should be up this weekend, dude. So look forward to that. Make sure you subscribe, of course. Right, let's get that melody. Here we go. Quick note on melody. Whenever you're learning melody, make sure you can sing the melody first in your head, okay? So for me, this first bit is just being able to just remember this melody. Dum, dum, ba da 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 da. Dum dum ba 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 ba. Okay, we need that in your head. Bum bum, and then you're gonna go through the scale. You know, this is the C minor scale, E flat major scale, and just find that note. Bum bum ba, bum bum. There it is. Dum dum ba bo ba bo. And I'm not just guessing notes here. I'm not a genius. I'm not George Benson here. What I'm doing is just using the notes of my scale. I know it's going to be one of those notes because it's within the key. It's a pop song. It's going to be fine. It's just finding it. Again, trial and error. Okay, let's just skip back a little bit. That's nice. It's just all pentatonic scale, guys. We're in happy land. I'm in my happy place when it's all pentatonic scale. No. Simple. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I'm going to really make a full one. So we've got the melody, we've got the chords. Okay, so ba 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 ba. Okay, so next up, we need to make this manageable as a beginner's thing. Now, I feel like it would be really relevant in the lesson to just show those chords as bar chords, but basically, fundamentally, do a picking version and add that melody to it. So I think here, in terms of the key of E flat major C minor, in terms of these chords that we're using here, I need to go to my cage system to work out where best to put the capo, because I'm not going to expect the beginner to come up here. You know, you can't do a, it's hard to a B flat major chord for a beginner, a C minor chord, all these chords are super hard. So we want to make it so you can just do your open chord shapes, okay? So I think, let me just think about this. So F minor, we could do it there. We could, I feel like potentially the D minor, da, 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 C minor, do, 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 E flat major. I'm going to go third fret, and I will tell you why. Just in case any of you guys are wondering. So I've got a couple of things coming in. Ollie said nailed it. Thanks, dude. Absolutely nailed it, might I say, on a first listen. Merv said, do you think this type of note melody selection is lazy? That's a really interesting question, actually. No, I don't think so. I don't think so at all. I think The Weeknd is just a very good pop songwriter. And at the end of the day, he's just looking for a catchy melody that sounds good. And I'm a huge advocate of the pentatonic scale. You know, most of where I go when I'm improvising, when I'm looking for melodies, is the pentatonic scale. Everyone knows it. It sounds great. And, you know, he's not looking to break any records here. He's not looking to break any musical boundaries. He's looking to write a really catchy pop song. And the pentatonic is where I would probably go for that. So in his, what he's trying to achieve, I think he smashed it. So if maybe I was a jazz musician and looking to write a song, I probably wouldn't go to the pentatonic scale for that kind of thing, Merv. Certainly not. But, you know, this is, it generally appeals to more people, I think, really. The simpler, the better. So, Camden says, good content, you inspire me to make more videos. Lovely. Merv says again, well, it's more Max Martin than The Weeknd, right? Exactly. Exactly, my friend. So let's just do this. So, if you're wondering why I put the capo on the third fret, how I came to that conclusion, basically, this is all about the cage chord system. Okay, if you're into the cage chord system or you want to learn about it, then go to our website and we've got all the intermediate courses are based around the cage chord system. Okay, you'll see them if you go to yourguitaracademy.com/courses. All the intermediate chord and rhythm courses are based around the cage chords, and it's so important because I've been able to do exactly this. So I know the chord is fundamentally an F minor. But I don't want to come up here and play it as a beginner, obviously. So I want to find place. I could, in theory, just put the capo here and just do it as like, you know, that's the kind of A minor shape. I've just now put the capo where my bar chord is. But again, this is very high up for a beginner. It's very intricate. It's kind of, the frets are very thin. Fretting chords like that is not ideal. So instead, I went to my cage chords and I think, well, there's loads of places to play the F minor. There. There. These are all just F minor from the cage chord system, okay? And that's so important to learn because then you can go, okay, well, which one should I start with? So I chose this one here, which is, you can see this bit is a D minor, just moved up, and I've made it into a cage chord, so I've got my root note here, okay? And that's given me a starting block because I'm quite happy with where I am. The third fret, the frets are still nice and big. And then I can go through the other chords using my cage chord system to see if I can find nice chords again close. So the second chord is a C minor. So there's a C minor chord here. Okay. And that is really close. And as you can see, if I put the capo here where my first finger is, that's basically just an A minor shape and that's a D minor shape. So that's a nice change for a beginner. Then the next chord is the E flat major. And again, E flat. That's an E flat note there, so I could play a major chord there. I just need to know, as long as you know your cage chords, you can do this. So you need to study the cage chords. So that C shape there is perfect because I know I'll just be able to play the C. And then when I go to the B flat major, again, there's a lovely cage chord right there, the G shape of the cage chord system. So I know I'll be able to just play a G major chord. So it changes from all those intricate, hard shapes, which are great for intermediate players, but for beginners, not great, to this. Tuning issue when I put the cap on, but not too bad. So there we go. Hey Mike, how you doing, buddy? I'm glad I decided to vlog as well. We're gonna try and do this as a weekly thing if people like it. I think it's just for me, you don't get much of this stuff on YouTube. You get the polished article at the end when someone's worked something out, but not so much of the person actually kind of going through the process of working it out. So that's kind of quite a good insight, I think. So there we go. So now let's have a little look at how this kind of comes together. So it's just one bar on each chord. Dun, 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 dun. Let's just make sure this all matches up to the song. I'm running out of time, 'cause I can see the sun light up the sky. So I don't overdrive. Okay, and then all I'd want to do is then just get the melody in that. So it's, if I come back to the note it starts on is this note. Okay, so I'm here. So I wonder if we can get that into the chords. Maybe we can make a little fingerstyle version here. Oh, I'm trying it on here. The song. Cool. So I think what I'll do in the lesson is just go through the chords like this, go through the chords for intermediates for beginners, and then it's a really cool track you can play along to, isn't it? Let's just see if there's a bridge. I can't teach you how to go. So, of course, this is classic Weekend. rhythm over these tracks. You know, there's no set rhythm, is there? You can do whatever you want. And the only thing to consider. I'd say it's all just on the one. Okay, yeah, amazing. Simple as that. Ollie says I need a whammy bar for that, which, yes. Try hooking up a whammy bar to this. It's not going to happen. But have a look at this. Have a look at this unfortunate event. Now, the camera's a bit slower than I am, so I can't see, but it is a little bit cracked. We've got a slight problem. It definitely needs to go to Mr. James Collins back in the UK, but that won't be happening anytime soon, unfortunately, thanks to the lockdown conditions. So, there we go. We've got two songs. So I'm going to be doing Killing Floor. I'll do a full video lesson of that, which will go up on Saturday. And we'll do this this Blinding Lights track by The Weeknd, which will go up on Sunday. The Blinding Lights will be a great one for beginners. We'll put the capo on. But we'll also talk a little bit more about that cage chord and everything else. I think it's really important to not totally dumb it down so that it gives people just that little extra something. So please do let me know if you're watching this now or if you're watching this later on. Let me know if this is something that you do still enjoy, want to see. And it's really cool to see where people are coming from. I really like that. We've got people from all over the world watching these videos. I really hope that everyone is okay and enjoying time at home. over here in Poland, I'm in Poland in Wrocław at the moment. Coming back, but not right now. Today is the first day where you have to wear the masks, which is really interesting. But hopefully wherever you are, you're safe and well. Do let me know if you've got any other questions. I'll just hang around for 5 more minutes. So if you've got any final questions, something you just want to go through, I'll just literally just kind of be noodling, because why not? Do you know what's really good fun? I'm just going to pop a backing track on. No, do you know what? Because I'm not sure the stream is synced. So I'll just have a little jam. Little blues. I like this kind of groove. So good, apart from my neck crack, which is unfortunate, but it's good. If I pop a little tube screen on it. Remember, any questions, guys, if you've got anything, let me know. What's this on my looper? Funk. Okay, this is... I'll just hang around for another couple of minutes. Here we go. Nice. Merv says, I only have an acoustic at the moment. I was wondering if you have any tips on or brands for an electric to check out fairly cheaply to relearn during quarantine. Yeah, I do, actually. I picked up this guitar, which I'm going to get now, from a company called Vintage. We've worked with them, you know... I should come close to the microphone. We've worked with them in the past, so I know they're just really good guys, and the guitars, I mean, this retails at, I think, £450, but look at it. I mean, it just looks like a Les Paul, doesn't it? I mean, it's obviously it's not, you know, but it plays really nicely. It's a chunk, it's quite heavy. You can feel that there's some serious wood there. Obviously it's a fair chunk away from spending £2,500 on a Gibson Les Paul. But for me, I've used it in loads of videos. I use it recording songs. It does the job. The pickups are actually pretty good. Honestly, I haven't adjusted anything on this at all. I didn't even adjust the action when it came in. This is it out the box, and I've used it for like a year now. So I really think it's a really good. I really honestly think it's a good guitar. And anything from this brand vintage, just look them up online. Obviously, they're not literally vintage guitars. It's vintage brand by JHS, I think, is the main company. They're good guitars, honestly. If you're going to spend, if you've got £500 or less to spend, I'd go for that, really. So, have a think about that. What else we got? Last couple of questions. Mike Thomas says, can you discuss the Bukinkos? Ah, well, I certainly can, Mike. We are aiming to have it all released on the 1st of May. So every month we're going to aim to do a brand new full course. And with the BB King, we're going to be talking in depth about his soloing approach, obviously his vibrato. We're going to be going through in great detail how you can play like him over a blues. He's got very specific ways of doing things, and he does very much move with those chords, you know. He's really just a genius as far as I'm concerned. And of course, you've got loads of different types of, he plays over your kind of standard 12 bar blues. He's great over a minor blues. He's obviously just an amazing singer. So we'll go through every aspect of his playing, like literally from ground up, building you to the point where you understand the scales, the arpeggios, the chords, and just really how to use his style and some of his tips and tricks. So it's going to be a great course. And the way we do it is that we have the full downloadable version with all the bonuses and the ebook and everything else available from our shop, which will be £19.99 in pounds from day one. But equally, you know, the whole point of what we do here at Your Guitar Academy is we want to make sure that everyone has access. So if you just don't have that money to spend, you know, that's though that cost really supports us. It helps us produce more videos. It kind of helps us pay the bills. So it's something that we've got a really good core subscriber base who do buy the courses. Of course, it means you can download it and use it offline, which is the main thing. Plus, in future, we will be adding more and more extras to those courses. Even if you've bought previous ones, we'll add more to them. So there's the cool stuff there. But for everyone else who can't afford that and they still want to learn, and we want you guys to have the best possible guitar education. So we'll actually be releasing the whole course on YouTube and on our website absolutely free, day by day. So lesson one on day one, lesson two on day two, blah, blah, blah. As we go through, we'll even include the tabs and everything on the website. So you can get everything for free, but then if you want to download it and own the course, and you know, without this kind of streaming online or being on YouTube, then you can buy it. So we're really excited about it, and BB King is just a great place to start for us. So we'll have more details coming up. So if you're not subscribed to our mailing list, then head over to the website, yourguitaracademy.com/courses, and there'll be a subscribe button for you to do there. You'll get a couple of freebies, of course. And please subscribe to us on YouTube, because obviously that's where all the updates are going to come. So Simon says, okay, I'm going to read this out. Bordo-o-gimru. That's Welsh, is it? No, where's that? That's Welsh, right? Tell me. Anyway, really enjoy seeing how you work stuff out. I have found it has helped me get better at it. Excellent. That's literally the exact point of this whole thing, as well as me just being on camera working out the songs I'm going to teach. Murph says, thanks, I'll check it out. And Leon, the last person to say hello. And of course, I have slightly rejected Instagram. I do apologize for that, guys. I find it very hard to follow the Instagram feed and say who's saying hello. We got Rob Allen. Rob. If you're still watching, I'm saying thank you. You're great. And this guy says, can you do some videos on how to compose songs? I think, you know, if people are enjoying this, then it's well worth doing videos on literally how to compose songs. We can probably do a full course on that, which I think will be really, really useful for people. So, anyway, Merv says, can you play the One of These Nights solo, lol? What's One of These Nights? Who's that by? The answer is maybe. Depends how much time you give me. Anyway, right, thank you so much for tuning in again, guys. We'll try and do these weekly. I'll try and do it at similar times each week as well, so that it becomes a bit more structured. Remember that we've still got tons of free courses. If you're sitting there twiddling your thumbs thinking about what to do on with your guitar practice and need a bit of direction, literally go to yourguitaracademy.com/courses and you will find a course there. They're absolutely free, or if you want to kind of help us out and pay for it, then you'll get the download version as well, of course, and all the extras that come with that. So that's it from me. I really hope you enjoyed that, and I will speak to you all soon. Thank you very much.